Hi, I'm Sonu from Living in Color with Sonu, and today I'm here with interior designer Daryl Carter. Now, many of us struggle when it comes to selecting the perfect palette for our homes. The nuance of selecting just the right color can be daunting. But Daryl's here to help us with an endorsed selection of colors from Benjamin Moore. So Daryl, tell us a little bit about how you came to create this palette of colors.
Well, I first want to say I appreciate the recognition that I actually do color, because I seem to have this misperception that I work only in beige and white. The color palettes that I work in actually are quite complex. They're driven often by the gravity of a rug or something else that we jump off of in the house. But it's about gradation, it's about shadow, and it's not just about white or beige or cream, although you'll see a lot of that here. It's about shadow and the interaction between the colors and the subtle gradation between, for instance, a wall and a ceiling mold that is in, you know, that's finished out in a different sheen, for instance. That too will create a difference. So you can even use the same color on your trim or on your baseboard. What I encourage is that you gradate through the house with some logic. So, you know, pick where you want to start and grade from there.
Well, you know, when you talk about whites, for example, a lot of people do, I think, naturally tend to think that white is white is white. But,
yeah.
I mean, is white a good indicator? I mean, does every company have the same whites, for
example?
Well,
no. Yeah. I wouldn't be sitting here. I don't do things unless they're authentic, incredible,
right,
and tried and true. And,
certainly.
And, you know, the reason that Benjamin Moore is the go-to for me is because there are so many different whites. And I work often in historic contexts. And I am, you know, I like to honor the architecture and the architect and the restoration. So shadow becomes relevant to me. And I think a lot of architects like working with me because I have such respect for architecture. Mm-hmm. So you can, with those slight variations in color, you can really emphasize a moment of architecture in a space through the use of shadow. And so the complexity of the palette, the white palette alone, is highly useful and informed.